So, here it is. October 21st, 2016. And I hear you saying, Black Knight. I've got till October 24th to make a lot of money, because probably more stuff's going to come out and I'm going to have to buy things. Or maybe there's stuff you want to buy that's already released, like that new Hakachu Drag, and you want to know, what's the best way for me to make money? Well, let me tell you my thoughts on the matter. You can agree with me or not agree with me. You can come up whatever you want to do there. One way you might be tempted to make money is in the slipstream events. And if you can get a whole bunch of your buddies together and do slipstream events, that is awesome. Because you need a good number. If you have a good number of people, you need at least four. Anything custom now and it's worth grabbing? No. You need at least four to do a slipstream event, and let me tell you something. Talking people into doing a slipstream event, very difficult. You could sit on there for half an hour waiting for people to join that lobby, because, I mean, the slipstream events are not popular. Personally, I kind of think the game mode is fun. It's different, it makes you think a little bit, it's not just blasting along as fast as you can go. I like it myself, and you can make, if you can get people in there, you can make it, you know, if you get people to want to put enough laps into it, enough rounds into it, you can make a ton of money. But it hasn't really, it's not something I can pull off consistently myself. I don't have a big enough crew to do this, you know, it's just not gonna happen. So, then you can say, well, you can always do biker stuff. Get on your bike and do all the biker missions and do, you know, the biker business missions. And that works perfectly well, too. You can make a lot of money that way. But, on the other hand, I'm not real tempted to do the biker business stuff. Simply because you have to invest into it. And then the daily, you know, the daily costs on that. The weekly costs, or at least, you know, where you have to pay, like, I forget, $5,000. Is it $5,000 a day per business? It's a stunning amount of money. So now you have to constantly be making money, or it's going to start draining your bank account. And for me, the biker stuff, all of the missions are basically CEO Part 2. I mean, there's a little bit more weirdness to them. There's no question about that. But it's CEO Part 2, so I'm not really that into them. But, I mean, you may be into them. That's a cool thing. That's another way to make money. So maybe I should cut to the chase here. You know, but let's say you just want to grind out a bunch of bucks. Maybe you're working on your bills, and you're doing some other things, and you're like, well, gee, how can I make money in GTA while I'm just kind of, you know, going along here and doing my thing? Well, let me show you. First of all, you got to get out of the solo session that I had to go in just to film this intro, because when I try to do it in a public session, this happens. So... people just won't leave you alone in this game. It's just how it kind of goes. Which is another problem with doing the biker missions. The business missions are locked to public sessions, and that takes away the consistency. I'm really looking for consistency here. So what we're going to do is we're going to leave the GTA Online session that we're in. I should be able just to find a new session, but sometimes that puts you back in another solo session. I don't know what it's supposed to do. So this pops out, pops back down. He's having a schmoke. Yes, we want to. We don't want to transfer characters. We want to play GTA Online. Go. And the reason you have to go to a public session is to do what I want to do. You have to be in a public session. Now, the good news is that this is one of the few times when the public session generally ignores what you're doing. Now, the fact that I'm recording this means it won't work. But, come on, load it up so I can get to the next part of the exposition. Let's do this. Come on, get me out of the clouds. I'm losing audience here. Would you get me out of the clouds? Come on. It is 7 o'clock in the morning on a Friday. This shouldn't be a problem. Let's go. Fine, let's do the time warp again. Alrighty, here we are.
That was sick. I actually made it all the way up here. Wow.
So you have to go to...
Dude, online. That's bullshit. Alright, let me try.
Rockstar playlist.
Alright, I'm doing it. Hold up.
The double money RP biker stunt deal. Well, this should shut down everybody else's mics once we get there.
Man, what the fuck? I just keep going right here.
Yeah, I love it. Mate, you need a lot of speed, man. You get a ton of speed. You can do it. I see you like roof jumping. That was sick.
Whoa! Almost fucking hit somebody.
Please silence them. Okay, so what you've seen here is that we've gone into the double money, double RP biker stunt playlist stunt race 1 of 3 by ourselves. That's right. Alone. Now, you say, but Black Knight, if you win a race with a whole lot of people, you get more money. And if you lose a race with a whole lot of people, you get next to nothing. We're looking for consistency here. Now, one nice feature of doing this alone is that it really doesn't matter how long it takes. Actually, it does matter how long it takes you, but you certainly don't have to do it fast. I think there might be some lag to whatever session I've connected to, because this is like, you're kidding me, right? I'm trying to film it. So you can stunt out like crazy on this. Get 100 RP every time you hit a jump. You can be as silly as you want to be. Whee! Completely trick it out. Down this side, and thread the needle. Whoa, there we go. We should get points for that. Now, the main point of this is not to make you watch me race a bike by myself, but the key thing here is you're going to want to make this race last 8 minutes. And one of the ways you can do that is just by stopping. I mean, just go do something, have breakfast. Maybe you have to hop in the shower real quick, you know. Work on your bills, work on your homework if you're still in school. Kids, if you're below a certain age, you really shouldn't be playing this game. Did you know if you can wheelie for a really long time, you get 50 points for that? Look at that. I mean, it's just, you know. If you're trying to level, this is great. Why is this lagging out on the jumps? That's exactly when I need it to work. This is, honestly, you gotta be kidding me. I thought that would have gotten more than 50. Why is this doing that? So I wonder if the regular jumps get you something too. They should. Okay, maybe they get you killed. But you ever wondered, can I reach the water? Yes, you can. You can literally stunt out like crazy. You can sandbox this, which I think is a great thing. Almost made it to the thing, but the... Okay, you don't even have to go over that jump, really. I mean, I don't even know if that's faster. Now, here's an interesting thing that will make you laugh. Did you know you could do this? That's right, you can pollute the ocean. These are a little trickier. And you can kind of ride them into the ocean if you or do this. It's those top four that are always the trickiest. Hard to get an angle on them. Come on. Come on. Once you get them past a certain point, they go in. Now, I've still got another 2 minutes to kill here. Just... Yeah! Literally kill. That's just... 2 whole minutes. You say, what's the magic deal with the number 8? Well, 8 minutes for races is usually, almost all the races really is how this works, usually the magic number by which you will get the most amount of money. It's usually $8,408. That's how much you normally get for an 8-minute race. It doesn't matter, you know, if you win. By yourself. Woo, that was as close as I could come without drowning. Now, obviously, if you've got 15 people in the lobby, well, then it's going to be a lot more money. But if you're got 50 people in the lobby and you're number 15, you're getting maybe a grand. Maybe you're getting $500, something like that. Even with the double money, if you're racing a lot of people, you better be good. And if you're really good, that's great. But we're talking about how can just about anybody make consistently good money in their spare time. What is going on with this computer, honestly? With the double money multiplier on, that means that for every 8 minutes, you're getting this. And nice part about it, other than the fact that the darn taunt thing is broken, the nice part about it is that it's a playlist, first of all. You get to do 3 of these, which gives you just about $50,000. Taking time in between rounds into account, conservatively, you're looking at $50,000 every half hour, which means $100,000 an hour. Now, it's pretty hard to get $100,000 an hour in this game. I know if you do Headhunter and stuff like that, people claim you can do more. But again, I don't know that you can pull that off consistently. It depends on how fast you are with everything. Headhunter and Sightseer, but I mean, that's always available. And that might be something to be good when they're not doing a double kind of dealio here. But you can do a lot of this, just crank through these. If you feel like stunting out, you can stunt things out. It's really cool. And you can end up making $100,000 an hour. Now, if you have a crew of people, then you might be able to make even more money by rotating who wins and having everybody wait out the 8 minutes. Of course, that might average out differently in the end because someone's got to be the loser, and that means they're not making money for that 8 minutes. I do not know what's up with the frame rates on this. This is just, now it's fine, then it's not. I'm thinking it's gotta have something to do with the session I'm in. It's just that way. $450 RP, there you go. There's one other trick there. I'm starting to wonder if it isn't faster to do it this way. Check this out. I wonder, are we on the wrong end of the jump here yet? No. Here we go. When you approach this jump, you hit the jump, you float for a little while. But what if you simply say, oh, no, heck with that, I'm not doing that. I wonder if that, it doesn't seem like it'd be faster. I mean, it'd be close though. If you got someone who's gonna bump you off the jump, might be worth a shot. You know, just an option for you in the future. But in the meantime, you can just go crazy. Let's go crazy! 200 RP. If you want a level, this is a nice little trick. I mean, the stuff will do, you know, clean lap bonuses for $100, so you really can't touch anything. This way you can just go crazy. 100 there, probably not too much there. And there's the lag again! That's too long a breath. Wow. Wow. I'm mesmerized by this problem. It's just wow. Okay, I thought I was gonna do a backflip off of there. You notice the physics is a little weird on this because really theoretically I shouldn't fly off to the right doing that. Backflip. I took a front flip. Flip-dee-doo-dah. But I landed on my back, so therefore. Physics with bikes is interesting. Wherever the bottom is facing, you get pulled in that direction. That's how they've worked the gravity out, and that's why you can do extreme flip-dee-doo kind of things and glide forever. You'll notice, see, I can pull it right, I can pull it left, I can pull it this way, I can pull it that way, I can crash into a wall. Still get 100 points. Whee! Uh-oh, we're gonna miss it, so I'll go down. See, if you aim down, it actually pulls you down faster. I think that's because it actually acts as a brake because your bottom of your bike's facing behind you. So therefore, it slows you down. Yeah, physics is definitely taking a holiday. Now, don't waste that 50 seconds because you'll lose $3,000. That's just the truth. You can see I'm leveling up like crazy. Still no... Rockstar, you gotta fix this. Come on. It only works at the end now. Sometimes. I think it works at the end now all the time. I don't know. Quick trick on the last one. You do not have to do 2 laps to get the most money on this. It is a long enough track. So set that to 1. Be lazy. We should call this the lazy method to making money. That's maybe that's what we'll call the title. That's probably not the way people search. Wait. We'll maybe we'll clickbait it. The best way to make money this week. And as you say this week, then people always think it's that week. Now, once this double money deal is over and the playlist is gone, you can pick up any race, absolutely any race, and still make $50,000 an hour doing the exact same technique. If it's a really short race, you need 2 laps. I think there's probably like a 1 kilometer limit or something like that on it. That's what I've noticed. I haven't done anything scientific with that to know if it's a 1 kilometer deal. But this is a long enough race, you only need 1 lap. It'll give you the full payout. I noticed on some of the air races, I think one of the air races you get penalized if it's only 1 lap. Yeah, Burn Your Bridge, I think, has to be 2 laps to get the full 8. But generally what I'm doing Burn Your Bridge is just to get a daily objective, either to fly under a bridge or... If you do this just right... I was gonna say, you can pick up the thing and not even land on the... I've actually skidded through it, gone off to the other side. It might actually be a little bit faster, but it's nearly impossible to do. Well, not possible. Difficult. There's a much higher chance that you'll just wreck. Whee! This one's in particular fun, because you get that extra kick right at the top. Things go crazy. Watch this. In a wheelie, boom! Did it? Did it? Wee! Ooh! Oh wow! He didn't land that one. Gotta do it again. Let's try the other side. Kicks you in a wheelie and you flip it around, baby. Yes! Off the top of the building. Yeah. You can stunt this out. Now, the nice thing about this... Where does that take you? Different part of the track? Can you get back up where you need to be? That's where you come down, I think. Yeah, that's where it comes down into the what you call. But there's other places you can get back up there. You can just drive back up and around. Probably not from here, but yeah, you can. Hold on, 1 second. So if we can slip up in here, see, you can just hit F and you're right back where you're supposed to be. But now you can, if you really want to be a purist, actually. Whee! Ugh. Now, if you're not into stunting, I mean, if this doesn't have any appeal to you, but you just want to make sure you have enough money for the whole Halloween deal, whatever they're going to come out with, Halloween-y kind of stuff, which is probably inevitable. I would be really shocked and surprised if they don't do some kind of Halloween Wonderland sort of dealio. There's stuff hidden in the game files, supposedly, if you listen to Mr. Boss for the win. It has all kinds of stuff that's supposed to come out. Halloween bikes and game modes and tributes to Tron and stuff like that. So you're going to need money for this. So let's say, you know, you can just do the race as fast as you want. Sit here and wait out the timer if you want to write your bills out. The one thing you don't want to do is let it go past 15 minutes because then you'll get timed out. And you lose the whole thing. Yes, that's, you know, one thing. Now, one thing I have done in the past, and I've shown this off, you put the bike into a wall, put something on the keyboard that holds a key down, like a screwdriver. You could do that, and this will keep your game alive for the whole time. You can leave it for an hour, come back, as long as your weight doesn't fall off the keyboard and you don't mind, you know, replacing keyboards or screens. If you're leaning something against the screen, that's fine. If you're making videos, it probably behooves you to get a little crazy stunting. Whee! Ooh. That was different. So, as you can see, I've waited out the timer. I can just hit F and then finish this really quickly. Or you can just mess with the game, you know? Go from the wrong side. Why not? Pop a wheelie into there, boom, right into the wall. Why not, right? It's a video game. You're not actually on the bike. You still get your 16,816. See, I'm just staring, looking, because that's what happens now. I'm going to go off and edit this video, so I'm going to continue. But now you can just hit restart, rinse, lather, repeat. You've already got $50,000. You do it again, you get $100,000. Basically, $100,000 an hour. It's beautiful. There's the taunt. See, it finally works. Here, someone's trying to try and do Slipstream 4. Should we try and see if we can get in on that? We can compare and contrast the two. By the time we get out of here, you'll be spectating. That's kind of how it goes. Let's do the time warp again. Alright, let's see here now. Go here. Invite to mission. That might be it. Yeah, that's it. Let's see if... He's probably still waiting for somebody. It's really hard to get people into Slipstream games. It's hard to get into Slipstream games. Let's see. Come on. Let's do this. Let's do this and pray that my frame rate holds up. I don't know if that's a hard drive issue or an internet issue. Or a video card. It shouldn't be a video card issue. My video card's not packing in. I've got a good video card. I could do this stuff all day long normally. I can record constantly. Normally I don't have this problem. I'm not low on hard drive space. So, we'll see how it goes. I guess we'll have to do the time warp again. Bippity boppity boo. This looks strangely like my apartment. What? I joined Slipstream, it puts me in my garage. What the... I think that just made one of my points, people. If you want to make consistent money, the double RP racing playlist for this week's the way to go. And that is how you do it, folks. And on that note, this is The Black Knight. Have a great night. See? $50,000 plus two for good behavior. And if you're wondering, why do you only have roughly $2 million if this is such a good method? Well, I do tend to blow the money as quickly as I get it. Yeah, that's kind of a problem. We're working on that. We're working on that. So there I am. I'm setting up just to record a video. Do a little talking. Got the perfect scene set up. And then you have to be a random dick. I mean, come on! What did that gain you? One more time. Come on. I got plans. They want to screw them up. That's fine. He's run away. Head to his house. So here it is. It is October 21st, 2016. And I hear you saying, Black Knight, there's 3 days left in this special event. This special event for... Would you stop talking through me? I'm trying to film here. Take two, fine. Get back in that position.